think that's like potential is like kind of a big misconception, if I'm personally like honest, because like all the time I feel like people do that with art. Like they like come up to me and are like, oh, I can't even draw a stick figure. And I'm like, yeah, bitch, because like you didn't like put like 5 hours a day into this since you were 10. Yeah. Like I have had so many friends, so many be like, oh, I want to do these, I want to get into these, and then like, but they make like one or two prints and then they don't keep going. Like it's because it's like it's a ton of work to have a whole wall of prints behind you, you know. I started out with like knowing not a ton but like a little bit, and like I've always been super lucky that like my original art sells really well. That is not true like for every other artist I've ever met. All the time like they're like, oh, I can't get my original art sold, and I'm like, that's what floats me over every con. Like even this last con, like a friend came up and she was like, what's your bestseller? And I was like, my original stuff. Like like it is every time. Can't be good for a con. Like that's just like not possible, you know. Like a flower can't be in bloom all year. Like
oversaturation, essentially.
Exactly. Like, you know, like it can't always like be great, but like, you know, sometimes it will just be like a blowout, you know. Honestly, this is why like I bought an iPad, is because like I need to be able to get work done while I'm still just sitting there waiting for things to happen. I'll meet a ton of people that are like, oh yeah, like her and me, like we've been friends since like 2013, but like we come to Sabakon every year, you know, we come to Rose City every year together. Yeah. So like it's a good like meetup things for people that like live across the country from each other too. So and like, oh, like this is better than that, you know, like, or like, you know, like even just like the gossip that we all did there, like I found out two cons that like absolutely don't do them, they're terrible, but I also found out about like two or three that like people were like, absolutely go for it, do it. Like the one thing that I always remember that like my college professor told me is like, he always like, because when I always would come to him and be like, how do I get jobs, how do I like freelance, and he was always just like, hustle, Janeal, like just get out there and hustle. And like I didn't actually, when I was in college, I didn't know what that meant, so I'd just be like, hustle, like I got this. Like I didn't though until like I got out and like I realized like hustle means like a consistency. Like I have the goal of, I need to post on social media at least once a week. So like once a week, like I've got something, whether it's like a stupid sketch or it's like a fully like finished painting, like I gotta have something because I gotta be like relevant still. Facebook has made it entirely so that unless you pay for a post, like none of your fan page stuff is gonna reach anybody.
Oh my God.
So like it was just kind of like, well, okay, I don't really care about this anymore. So
everyone make your final sales. Artist Alley closes now. Make your final sales. Artist Alley is closing now.
You see really great art and you can see that yours isn't there, like and I think that's really important, because like that means you have like perspective, but like also like you need to realize you'll get there, but you need to keep going. Like, and like that person who has that amazing art or that amazing podcast or like that amazing like documentary or whatever, like they worked their butt off probably every day for that, like in some small ways, some big ways. I guess like a person doesn't feel like they're at that like spot, you can get there, like and you can have fun doing it on the way.